jar. Don't gotta be cool. I mean, you know, you don't have to be cool. But you gotta get funky with it. That's important. Hi there, I'm Kenny. It's the Animal Farm. Yeah. It's Friday. The weekend is here. It's been a crazy week. Your grown-ups probably need a little extra hugging this week, after this week. So, yeah. So be nice. Be kind. Take it easy on them. And enjoy your weekend here on Kids Place Live. You can always play around with us, too, by calling 1-866-328-2345. We want to say hi to Tim, Big Dirk the Fourth and Forgotten Chipmunk fan. Thanks for calling in. Drew wanted to know if I could bring the entire Animal Farm to his house, which is not recommended. You'll never get the smell out of your carpet. It's just not good. And Isaac is also a big fan of Dirk the Fourth and Forgotten Chipmunk. Lots of people leaving messages for our British furry dude with an attitude. Again, the number 866-328-2345. Press 2 for the Animal Farm.
Somebody's on the phone!
Hi, my name is Hannah, and I'm
6 years
old, and I'm from Canada. And I would like to ask Dirk a question. What does Dirk look like? My mom pictures him, mohawk, goatee, leather jacket with biker glasses. And I picture him, top hat, monocle, handlebar mustache with a suit.
you know, it is. It's difficult to pin me down, isn't it? You know, because I'm a bit of a fashion, you know, plate. I can do lots of things fashion-wise. It's very, very tough to imagine. I know. Because you hear this voice and you're like, what does he look like? You've got to know.
Sure.
The truth is, if I can be honest, can I pull back the curtain a bit?
Sure, yeah. Be my guest.
All right,
go
so
ahead.
The truth is, I'm a bit of both, you know. I am a leather jacket and a moustache, all right, you know. I've got the mohawk and the monocle, you know, it's a little bit of both, right?
Yeah.
You know, I've also got the biker glasses and the monocle.
You do?
Which is crowded on the face. I've got the monocle.
Yeah, how does that work?
It's important because the monocle's corrective, but only for one eye, which I don't understand because.
Right.
Anyway, the thing is, I've got a bit of all of it, you know,
okay.
It's a bit of all styles. It just depends upon my mood, you know, really. It depends upon my mood.
Well, I think what they're trying to get a sense of is what you look like actually physically.
Well, that's kind of hard to describe, is it? Well, yeah.
What?
I suppose, you know, think of me as a small, furry, graying, brown Idris Elba.
What?
Yeah. Yeah.
Really?
Well, that's pretty much
Elba.
You know, we've been mistaken for each other. It's a bit awkward. It's happened at times, especially when you had the beard.
Yeah,
it was a thing.
I could just see how that could happen.
With a bit of Brad Pitt thrown in.
Oh,
yeah,
Brad Pitt too.
Because there's
sure.
a bit of, because I got the longer fur, so there's a bit of the Brad Pitt.
Yeah,
but it's that unexplainable charisma that we all have. That's probably the closest thing that I could do to describe me.
So you're a short, furry Idris Elba, Brad Pitt mix.
Or maybe a much shorter Kevin Hart, Jonah Hill, you know,
right.
combination on a... On a different day, it's
a workout.
Either way, the point is,
yeah.
I look like a famous person.
Okay.
With a goatee and a monocle and a suit and a top hat and a leather jacket and a.
Okay.
I'm going to stop talking now.
Okay, that's good.
Okay.
All right.